Welcome to class 34 of Secretarial Practice. So in this class we are going to study regarding the liabilities of the directors. So the first, the liabilities of directors are classified into the groups. So group like liability to the company, liability towards the outsiders, criminal liabilities. So the first is liabilities to company. The directors of the company do not incur any personal liabilities as long as they act within the power and in a good faith, right? So liability is, or the term liability comes into existence in the term or in the term office of your director. So when they are going to do something wrong, when they go beyond the power, so when they are not faithful enough, so however they become personally liable to the company. So like for acting ultra vires, the company act, for the instance, so payment of dividend out of capital. Okay, so what is this ultra vires? So ultra vires means beyond the power, right? So beyond the power we call it as ultra vires. So here ultra vires to the company act. So company act says that whenever you are going to pay the dividend to the shareholders, so it should be provided out of the dividend or divisible profit, right? So when you are going to provide the dividend to the shareholders out of the capital, so it is something which is against the company act. So for that case, so the director is going to be liable. And the next is for the breach of trust, right? So how this breach of trust and for making secret profit. So how this director is going to breach the trust? So breach means you are going to break, right? So trust. So he is a trustee, or he is a trustworthy person, we say. So directors, why he become trustee? So as we have studied in the previous classes, so we call him as trustee. Why he is called as trustee? Because he is going to hold and manage the property. So he is going to hold the manage and property of the company. So he is going to have the fund and property of the company. So for the benefit of the company only and not for meeting his personal end. Okay. So here, as a director is entrusted with the property of a company and the company has a trust in the directors, if he fails to protect the property, if he misuses the fund of the company, so he commits the fraud called as breach of trust. The next is secret profit. What is this secret profit? So profit means, you know, secret means, secret is the meaning of secret also, you know. So here, so it is a profit or advantage. So it is made by the directors of a company. So because of his official position. So you are having an official position. You have the powers. You have some duties. You have some rights. Okay. So misusing that and earning the money, we call it as secret profit. So this profit is made without bringing the transaction to the attention of the stockholders. Okay. So you do something by the virtue of your office, you earn profit, so but it is not known to the shareholders, which means by misusing your position you are going to earn the profit. So that we call it as secret profit. Then the next is for acting dishonestly. So how the director is going to act dishonestly? So honesty should be there, right? So as he is a trustworthy person, he should be honest enough. So buying a property for the lower price and selling the same to the company at the highest price. So what happens is not going to act properly, right? He is acting dishonestly. The next is for gross negligence in performing their duties. So here gross negligence means reckless. So like careless, I'm not cared about. So whatever may happen. So whatever duty he has to perform. So like determining the minimum subscription, holding the statutory meeting, you have to file the statutory report. So general meeting should be conducted. So there are various duties to be performed by the director. And if he fails or neglects to perform this duty, he will be liable. Then the next is willful misconduct. Misconduct means the work what you are going to do. Misconduct means a wrong work what you are going to do. We call it as misconduct. So that you are going to do willingly. So when any mistake done intentionally, we call it as fraud. So misconduct here is also a fraud. So how we are going to make a fraud now? So I have said you are the trustee of the company. Being a director, you are the trustee. So now you have the fund of the company. So what you do, you use it for your personal purpose. So it is said that as a trustee, you should use the property or the fund of the company for the company's purpose only, and for the benefit of the company only, and not for meeting your personal need. Okay, but here what they do is they are going to use the funds for their personal purpose. So that becomes liable to the company. The next liability is liabilities to outsiders. So how you will be responsible for outsiders? So we say director as an agent. So he is an agent between the company and the outsiders, right? So here, for non-disclosing the material facts. So where you are going to disclose the fact normally? So which will convey it to the outsiders? Only going to the prospectors. The company position, what is the company doing? So all things will be known by the outsiders. So in prospectus itself, you are not going to disclose the material facts. Okay, so there are various facts to be mentioned in the prospectus. So like information relating to the company should be there. Address of the register office of the company. So then relating to the present issue, relating to the project, so then the general information. So all these are the information which must be there in the prospectus. And if you are going to neglect or you are not going to disclose the material fact in the prospectus, you will be liable. Okay. The next is for making irregular allotment. So what is this irregular allotment? So irregular allotment means, so without receiving the minimum subscription, without receiving the application money, so what you do, you are going to allot. Okay, so that we call it as irregular allotment. So irregular allotment is nothing but, so you, for allotment of share, it has its own procedures, right? So it has its own procedure to allot the shares. So what you do here, you are going to make an allotment, or when we do not have the minimum subscription, or when we have not received the application money and you are going to allot the share, so that we call it as irregular allotment. The next is borrowing money in excess of company's paid up capital. So you know what is paid up capital. So whatever shares are being subscribed, so for each one, for each share 100 rupees we can say, but what you do, you are going to receive more than that. So you are going to receive 150 per share. So this is called as you are going to borrow the excess money of company's paid up capital. Then the next is for signing the negotiable instruments without mentioning the name of the company. So whatever you do, you have to do on behalf of company, right? So you are not going to mention the name of company, but you are going to sign the documents like check and all negotiable instruments. So at that time, the directors will be liable. The next is for acting fraudulently. So what type of fraud you are going to perform as a director? So you may misuse the fund, you may neglect something, you may harm the interest of the third party, you may breach the contract with the third party. So all these things are the fraudulent activity which you are going to conduct. The next is criminal liabilities. So criminal liabilities says that you are going to issue the prospectus, but it contains misstatement. So you may understood or you may know the difference between non-disclosure of material fact and misstatement. Misstatement means you are going to give the wrong statement. Non-disclosure of material fact means you are not at all going to disclose it. Okay. So for example, you do not say the truth. Okay. so something happened, somebody is going to ask you what happened there, but you are not going to reveal it. So that is called as non-disclosure. Okay, but here misstatement means, so two friends are fighting there, you say no, they are playing with each other. So misstatement, wrong statement given in the prospectus. So what happens when the wrong statement given in the prospectus? So even though you have the profit, or even though you are having the loss, you show that you have profit in the company to attract the shareholders. So what happens? It is a misstatement contained in the prospectus. So what happens here? The people go through that. So they think that it is right and they are going to invest in the company. So they will suffer the loss if the company is making loss. Okay. The next is fraudulently inducing persons to invest money in the company. Fraudulently inducing person means, so to invest in the company, it has some certain procedures. You have to subscribe the shares. You have to give the application. So then the allotment will be done. So all these procedures are there. So without that, having an influence of director, so if you are directly having the shares of the company, what happens? So it is called as fraudulent activity. The next is failure to hold AGM. So it is the duty of the directors to hold the AGM and they have to make a necessary arrangement for that. So what happens here is, if you are not going to hold the AGM, annual general meeting, you will be held criminally liable. The next is to hold the directorship in more than 15 companies. So we have already studied. Suppose you are a director of 15 company and if you are going to appoint as a director of 16th company, so any one office which you are already holding, so that you have to vacate. So if you fail to do that, so you will be liable. The next is for granting loan to the directors without obtaining the permission of central government. So company are allowed to grant a loan in which the directors are interested. So subject to, one is the shareholders' approval should be there by passing the special resolution and also by the central government permission. The next is failure to keep the register of member. So shareholders, member, how much shares are allotted to them. So all these records should be kept by the director. So making allotment without receiving the amount of minimum subscription. So making allotment without receiving the amount of minimum subscription is nothing but your irregular allotment. So failure to file the copies of special resolution with the registrar. So soon after the meeting, whatever resolution has been passed, within 30 days of passing the resolution, you have to file that resolution with the registrar of the company. And if you fail to do that, you will be personally liable. The next is making false declaration of solvency of the company. False declaration. So false declaration means, so the company is not, whether the company is having a profit, whether the company is suffering the loss. So what is the exact thing? So that you have to disclose. Okay. So suppose the company is incurring loss, you show that it is earning profit. So if suppose the company is having a good profit, you may show that you are going to or the company is incurring loss. So all this manipulation is not allowed. So acting as a director even after removed by the court. So it is said that, so directors will be removed. So there are various reasons to remove the directors, as we have studied already, right? So how the directors will be removed? So the directors are removed from their office if they are going to hold the office. So hold the office even after it is vacant. So they may be removed by the shareholders, they may be removed by the central government, or they may be removed by the court sometime. So even after their removal, if they are going to attain the office or continue, so that will be the criminal liability. Thank you.